Hello, my name is Tony, and I'm here to show you how to use the WC online system for scheduling appointments. If you are a new user, you must first create an account. Do so by selecting the link that says, "Click here to register." Complete each field like you would for any web service. Please note that your WC online account is separate from your USFSM NetID account. Once you've made an account, log in using your email address and password, and select the schedule you would like to view. Each schedule corresponds to a different service. After logging in, you'll see your selected schedule for the current week. You can navigate between schedules and weeks by using the drop-down and navigation buttons at the top of the page. Consultant names are located on the left, along with details regarding the types of appointments they are available for. To make an appointment, select an available appointment time, shown in white. When you click on an available time slot, a new window will open. Complete all of the required fields. You'll find contact and other information for the consultant for your appointment at the top of the appointment window. Depending on the service, you may be able to adjust the time of your appointment. Minimum and maximum allowable times will vary depending on the schedule. If the consultant is available for both face-to-face and e-tutoring appointments, you'll be presented with a choice between the two here. Once you've completed all of the fields, click Save Appointment. At this stage, you may be presented with an opportunity to attach a file to your appointment. If you've selected an e-tutoring consultation, please be sure to do so. If you are not ready to attach a file at this time, you can do so later. First, close this window, and later on, use this yellow folder, located towards the top of your window, to attach a file to your existing appointment. Please note that this feature is disabled for schedules where it does not apply. Finally, once you've made your appointment, you will receive an email confirmation, which will include instructions for changing or canceling it if the need arises. That's it for this tutorial. Please remember that if you need any help, you can contact Learning Support Services or the Information Commons Academic Resource Desk. We'll be happy to assist you.